Hey everybody, what's up? You're listening to the Minutemen. I'm your host CT Rob with CT Squid.
How you guys doing?
I'd like to throw a shout out to our Twitter followers. I'm Hope Bears, Lyra Gavry, Nancy Hayfield Barnes, Trump Killed Nawa, Brad ATC, Paris Seekers and I, Roll Kamir, Joseph M. Sorry if I butchered that one. Celine Anna Mack and Anna Stefan. Thanks for the follow, guys. We have a great show for you here today. We're going to be talking about the issue that everyone's talking about, of course, which is Russia. And if you know as well as I do, if you followed our show, you know that we were talking about this first. We've been talking about Russian involvement since the day after the election. All right, let's get started. I had an interesting article that I found from the Express today.
Oh?
Yeah. So apparently, there was a War of the Worlds. Basically, the title of this article goes, War of the Worlds, plane seen attacking UFOs in bizarre dogfight. Bizarre-looking UFOs were surrounded by an aircraft which fired at unidentified objects during a terrifying nighttime dogfight. It has extraordinarily been claimed. Investigators at the Mutual UFO Network, or MUFON, have received a report claiming the aerial battle was witnessed by a man in Circleville, Ohio, on Monday evening. U.S.-based MUFON is the world's biggest organization dedicated to UFO and alien research. So, yeah, there apparently was a UFO battle over Ohio.
You know, I'm surprised I didn't hear about this.
I didn't hear about it. Yeah, I was surprised either. This is actually
quite interesting.
Yeah.
This is a UFO battle.
Over Ohio.
Why Ohio? That's the main thing that's running through my mind. I mean, why Ohio?
I don't know. Because, I mean, not Washington, D.C. or, you know, Area 51 or, hell, even Phoenix, you know?
Well, you know.
Hell, Sedona, but, yeah, Ohio.
It's kind of interesting. I mean, I could understand Washington, D.C., because that'd be kind of like Independence Day.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
I know. That's my main thinking. That'd probably be like the coolest thing I ever saw in my life.
Yeah, I never saw Independence Day, too.
I did.
Did you like it?
I did like it. I mean, it was different, but like a lot of people already know this. They're trying to make it into like a whole series now. They're gonna do an Independence Day 3.
Oh god!
I know, and that's what really
is Will Smith gonna
off.
Be in this one?
Oh no, he died.
Wow!
They killed him off. I'm sorry if I'm spoiling this.
No, I probably will never plan to see it.
Oh, so. For those who are kind of thinking about it, and I know a lot of our listeners have probably seen it, and we're really disappointed. I mean, the end for 2 was probably the worst ending I ever saw in my life because it basically spoils the whole thing, saying we're going to space and taking care of these aliens once and for all.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah, I've never seen that one. You know, when I saw they were even making number 2, and I heard Will Smith wasn't even in it, I was like, I don't care.
I know, it really pissed me off. But I'm always a fan of Jeff Goldblum.
Yeah, so am I.
I've probably seen everything he's done. Oh, I love The Fly.
The Fly's amazing.
It is. I'll always love him in Jurassic Park.
Yeah, he is awesome. Yeah. Actually, he's what I think makes Jurassic Park 2, you know, The Lost World, good. If that was anybody else in that movie, it would not have been good. Personally, I think he just has that persona and that effect to carry a film like that. Because I thought it was a poorly written film, personally. But my favorite part is, which is an expression I like to use all the time, is, you know, don't go into the long grass, man. There's raptors in the long grass. Don't go into the long grass. That's like my favorite part of that whole movie. Yeah, you know, I don't know. I think this is it's an interesting story. MUFON is very credible, in my opinion. They do good research. Yeah.
I've heard of them, and I do give them credit. They do all their credit, or all their background on this.
They do. They actually had a show a long time ago. It was their own little show, but they actually got it canceled because, they actually were very critical of a lot of a lot of stories. They actually debunked a lot of the stories that came
on
the show.
I heard that,
so
yeah.
There was the show, I'm just speaking purely out of opinion here. I think that's probably why it was canceled, is because, there was no, it made people disbelieve more than it, you know, believe. Yeah. But that's the whole point to things like that, though, is you gotta sift through all the fakes to get to the good stuff. And trust me, the good stuff is there. I mean, there are cases that are really, really, really good, like Rendlesham Forest is good. Another good case, and this is if you're wanting to delve deep into what I like to call, third level UFO and alien belief, is Delcy, New Mexico.
Really?
Yeah, and that's when you believe that is the government and aliens working together. But yeah, that's the Delcy one. There's all kinds, you know, man. There's Roswell, of course, but Roswell is getting so old that it's getting hard to investigate that one.
Oh, I mean, it's because it's probably the most famous.
It is the most famous. There's actually, yeah, it is. It is the most famous, of course. It is. The Phoenix Lights is also up there too. Is another one too.
I know.
A lot of people still talk about that here. I know plenty of people that are still obsessed with that event. Actually, we'll be covering that too on the show. But anyway,
I was about to say we should bring it up.
No, we will. We'll be covering that. But yeah, you know, those are always interesting cases with a lot of credibility. Sedona has had a lot of interesting. Sedona is actually a UFO hotspot.
Well, I really want to go up to Sedona. I miss it.
Yeah, Sedona is a great place. I love Sedona. To all our listeners up in Sedona, we love you guys.
Yeah.
But let me ask you, Squid. Do you believe in UFOs?
I do believe in UFOs.
Well, like, what to the degree? Do you believe in the, like... Because, like I've said before, I believe there's, like, three levels. There's the level of the government denies it, but the people know about it. And then that's level one. And then there's level two of where the government knows about it, but they you know, there's nothing they can do about it. And then there's level three of where, like, the government knows about it and they work with the aliens. So it's like, what do you believe? Do you believe that, you know, like, there's the government, you know, they don't know about it at all. They're just like, it doesn't exist. Or do you believe they do know?
And they're working on
it. And they're working. What do you think? What do you think? It's level one, two, or three? Which one?
Honestly, I'm going to...
How far do you think it goes? Level two?
I would really like to see it be three, but I mean, to me, that kind of seems like a dream a little bit.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. I go as far as two as well. I think I truly do think it's a situation of where the government knows about it, but they can't do anything about it.
Yeah,
but they do reverse technology. They do, but then they don't have any. They can't do anything about it. I mean, the technology's beyond them. That's honestly what I think. I think that it's out of control.
Yeah.
I think everything... I don't think they're working with them at all. I think, you know, there's so many crazy stories out there. One of them, have you ever heard about the deal that Truman made with the Greys?
I think we've talked about it, but we never went into discussion. I know I've heard of it.
Apparently, Henry Truman, you know, the president at the time, met with the Greys. And they negotiated a deal in exchange for technology. They were allowed to abduct people, and this is where I told you that level three is where do you believe that the government is actually working with them? Now the Delcy story too. They believe that aliens are working there in Delcy. They believe that there is actual UFO. Extraterrestrials working with the government, experimenting on humans. And some of these, I wish I knew the name of the reports right now. There's been a few reports that have come out of Dulce, New Mexico, that talk about strange things. One of them was apparently from a security guard that snuck out information, and basically he drew some pictures from photos that he said he tried to take, and he said there's seven levels. The last two, six and seven, are known as like the nightmare levels. That's like how far you go down, the more like crazy and scary things get. Yeah. He said there was, like, they were growing people in vats.
What?
Alien hybrids. You know, everything and anything you can think of, alien conspiracy-wise is, like, apparently in Dulce. And what's crazy is there was actually, a conspiracy about Dulce itself, in which the base, there was apparently, the rumors are that there was this battle between aliens.
Another battle.
Between aliens and the people that work there. Apparently, the aliens went rogue. But see, this is what's scary about this story is, though, is that people who go up there and investigate up there in Dulce, because it is under guard. You can't go. It's in a mesa. I should just point out it's an underground base, supposedly, in this mesa. Now they do have people stationed up there, and people have asked them. If you ever watched the UFO Hunters back in the day, an old show, they went up there and they asked them. They said, "Hey, can you tell us what happened back?" I can't remember the day of the so and so when there was when a lot of people got hurt, and they said they don't like to talk about that day. But rumors are though that there was like some kind of rogue, and I've heard this with and without aliens in it, that there was some kind of like rebellion or rogue faction that took place in Dulce, and they had to literally send government officials in there to kill these people or to kill the scientists. I've heard all kinds of crazy things, but you know, you don't really know because this base is so. I mean, this base is probably more secret than Area 51.
Seriously?
Yeah, it's
wow.
You never heard of Dulce?
No, I mean, I've heard like a couple of conspiracies that like been connected to it. But I never knew like where this place was, and it was there. I mean, even more famous.
What's even crazier about it even goes deeper into that, the conspiracy about it even goes to the idea that there's underground roads, like an underground rail system that goes underneath Dulce to Area 51 to Denver Airport.
I would believe that.
Yeah, you believe in the Denver Airport conspiracy?
Oh, of course. I mean, people have named it Hell on Earth.
Really? No, I never knew that.
Yes, that is like the worst place you ever want to be is...
Denver Airport?
Yeah, they say it's hell.
Why?
Because of all the shit that goes there.
Interesting, okay.
It surprised me. It's a popular conspiracy theory, too.
What, Denver Airport?
Yes. I've seen online that every time I'm looking at conspiracy theories.
Yeah, it's
it goes to that one.
Well, do you believe in it? Do you think it's a real bunker?
I mean, parts of it do sound like it's real, but there are some holes into it that I still don't believe.
Well, I guess our listeners can put this in a book. Whatever you guys want to write down about something about C.T. Robb. Now, C.T. Robb here talks to a lot of Masons. I do. I know a lot of Freemasons. And that is one of the connections, supposedly, to this conspiracy, is that Denver Airport is built by the Masons. There's actually a plaque with the Mason symbol on it. Oh. Interestingly enough, I asked my source, who I know, who's a Mason. He is a... I will not give his name. I will not tell anybody who he is, but he's a Master Mason.
Really?
He's head of this. He's head of his lodge.
Wow, that's cool.
I pick his brain a lot on a lot of different issues. Some things are really interesting. Other things are really kind of scary. I've asked him before. I said, "So, what conspiracies like are true? Like, what do you feel comfortable enough telling me?" I asked him. I said, "Is Washington D.C. built around a Masonic architecture?" And he was just like, "Oh, absolutely." Yeah, he said absolutely.
Well, I know you've picked his or talked about conspiracy theories with him before because you brought him up before.
Yeah,
in one of our previous shows.
One of the things he said to me too was, I said, he said, "Yeah, you know, it doesn't matter." I said, well, would you ever?" I said, "What?" I told him, I said, "Do you believe all the conspiracies that people say about you guys? Like, you know, do you actually believe in it? Like, do you think there's stuff you don't know?" And he said, "Well, no." He says, "I already know what there is and what there isn't." He goes, "And what's funny is everything that's out there is out there, and people either believe it or don't believe it." He's like, "But it doesn't matter, because we've already taken over the world."
What?
Yeah, that's what he told me.
Wow.
That's what he told me. But when I came to, but back to Denver Airport, though, is when I was talking to him, though, I said, "So, do you think it's a real place?" And he refused to tell me. Yeah, he didn't really want it. He kind of hinted. He was like, "Well, you know, well, I'm not going to." I was like, "But there's a Mason symbol there, and it's a company that doesn't exist." And he's like, "Well, you know." He's like, "That's just all hearsay and this and that." And then I said, "But, you know, there's enough, they say there's enough water and electricity there and fuel that there's like to power a whole little city.
Yeah.
I said there's not, you know, why
that's a part I believe.
I said that's not necessary. And he's like, well, you know, and just kind of smiled at me and just. But that's it. I've been trying to get him actually to come on the show, but he's good. So that's why I'll just tell you, I'll just name him as my unknown source. But yeah, he is a Mason. He's a true
man,
Mason.
Man, I would really love him on the show.
I
want to pick his brain.
He's really an interesting guy. But we're going to be right back. We're going to take our first break. We'll be back.
Let me introduce myself. I'm a social disease. I come for your wealth. Leave you on your knees. No time for feeling sorry. I got here on my own. I won't ask for mercy. I choose to walk alone. What's yours is mine. What's mine is mine too. If you shake my hand, better count your fingers. What if I do get caught? What if there is no judgment? If I'm right, I lose nothing. If you're right, I lose it all. Why gotta get caught? Because I'm doing something wicked. I'm guilty, haunted by my fears and the ugly consequences.
And we're back. All right, guys, we're going to get into the beef of the topic today and what everybody is talking about, but what we were talking about first.
Damn right.
Now, DC right now has more leaks than Squid's Tank right now. And that's bad. I mean, you know, we've been hearing so many reports going on, some about Trump's morale being the lowest it's ever been. Apparently, they can't even... They can't even talk to him unless it enforces his own views. But, you know, let's get to the beef, guys. Russia. Russia, Russia, Russia.
Mother Russia.
How right were we?
We were too right.
We were too right, guys. We were talking about this from the first day of the election. I told you guys about Paul Manafort, and I told you guys about Carter Page. Both these two people are actually starting to come up again. Paul Manafort more so than Carter Page is, but there's just a ton of things going on, guys. The leaks out of the White House are just left and right. We got Trump gave a statement first of all saying that he didn't know anything about Michael Flynn, about the report, about the whole situation, even though it was later proven that he had known for apparently 13 weeks.
You know what's funny about that? I love how he's like, I didn't know anything about it, yet you have one of your advisors, we're going to go into later, goes on national media saying that he has full 100% support by him. Yeah, he knew nothing of his actions. He supported him.
Are
100%.
You talking about Kelly Underby Conway?
Oh my God! Are you talking? You mean Kelly? No, you mean Kelly Skeletor Conway?
Right.
Dude, have you seen her face lately, dude?
My God.
You know what? She even looks right now like she's even sick of the bullshit she's saying.
Yeah,
she's
just like, is.
Do I really have to keep coming out here lying? I mean, I'm just done.
General Flynn has the entire backing of Trump.
Hey, man. I mean, media.
All right, well, you bought this, and I've told Rob about this. Sean Spicer and Kellyanne Conway are telling two opposite stories.
Yes, they are.
Yes.
They are.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know if you've been noticing.
I was just about to get into that, yeah.
Yeah, on live television, no less.
You got the president, Kellyanne Conway, and Sean Spicer both just talking... However, out their ass, you know. And apparently, poor Mike Pence was lied to for 15 days. And see, that's what everyone's kind of getting into, though, a little bit, is everyone's kind of like, oh, he lied to the vice president. Who cares? Politicians lie to each other all the goddamn time. Who cares? That's not the story. What I think is the bigger story, and what people aren't really talking about, is how... Flynn made these calls to Russia under Obama's administration, so while Obama was still in the White House, he basically said, hey, don't worry about those sanctions, guys. We're going to lift them. Now, those aren't the sanctions for Crimea. Those were the sanctions for the hacking, supposed hacking, or the involvement in the election. But, you know, it's kind of funny that, you know, it's almost like a like I've been saying, it's like a bad movie. So we got the timeline here. So it went from Carter Page, Paul Manafort gets investigated, Carter Page gets investigated. They both leave the campaign when they're running.
Yeah.
During the time when Paul Manafort and Carter Page were there, the RNC platform for Donald Trump actually put more favor for Russia.
Ooh.
Yeah. You know, then you had the exiting of Paul Manafort for investigation. Yeah. Then you had the dossier come out, which now has actually been the blackmail file has been proven. Not the piss gate, which, believe me, guys, I wish it was real. But it's not.
It's not.
It's not. Well, who knows? It could be. Because actually what is real is the conversations that have been reported. They have actually been backed up and been found to be proven true. Some of the more scarier things going on with this whole thing, too, is how the sources in the NSA are deliberately now claiming they're withholding information from Donald Trump. Because, quote, the Kremlin is in the White House. Now, I don't know if that's as scary to you guys as it is to me, but that's pretty scary.
Here's the thing why it's just, oh man, I mean, it's just so much shit, but like, yeah, the whole thing about whether or not Michael Flynn was working by himself the whole time.
Yes, that is what I was just going to get into. That is the big question. Did Trump know? Did he give the order for him to make the phone call?
Dude, how can he, really? Michael Flynn, okay, was the mastermind behind this, going behind their back, lying to the vice president for, like you said, for 13 weeks. That's over a month. Really, they didn't know for an entire week. Oh, he's lying. You know what? We have a rat. We have a mole. He needs to be resigned. Now he resigns, right? Now, again, he resigns only after 24 days, which is the lowest.
Yeah,
I saw that.
Lowest, dude. And, I mean, he's hitting all type of lows in the... We're talking about lowest of the low. Like, I'm not going to get into it, but President Trump, his approval rating...
Oh, they're bad. They're atrocious.
50% lowest.
He's in the high 30s.
Yeah, but he's the fastest ever taken a president.
It's pretty bad.
Well, but see, with approval... Approve ratings. The highest they can go is a 33, and that's inauguration goes up only higher as soon as they take office.
It's supposed to.
Yeah.
And if he's in that low 30s, I mean, he's just below that line already.
Yeah.
And it's really sad to see, but to us, it's funny because we all knew.
Yeah, we all knew it. No, like I tweeted out, anybody who follows this show, you guys should not be shocked by the Flynn scandal.
No,
because
you
this whole administration, I'm just going to say it outright. I'm going to stop placating. And I'm just going to, I full on believe at this moment it is tainted by Russia. They even have reports that Flynn might have even been blackmailed.
Oh,
was being blackmailed by the Russians.
They were saying that he was subject to blackmail from Russia and he was an immediate threat. But at this point, you're even sugarcoating it with what you just said.
Yeah.
Russia is legit, like, balls deep in the Trump administration.
In the Trump administration.
They're pretty much just balls deep.
And if you say, well, you know, I believe Julian Assange says they didn't do that.
Oh, my God.
Guys,
dude,
those on the left, and I know a few of my favorite talk show hosts that are still playing this narrative, for those on the left that are still saying Julian Assange, they're using the Julian Assange offense, saying, well, you know, he doesn't really lie, he's never put out anything that's been, you know, discredited. Okay, well, that may be, but the fact is, though, I have a couple things I want to point with Julian Assange to. One of the things we were also speaking about on the show is how Edward Snowden was going to be taken. We made a joke. We joked about it. Squid made a joke about it and said that they're going to put a bow on Edward Snowden. And then I said, you know, they probably will give him up. And a little behind the scenes about the show. After the show, Squid texted me the next day and says, oh, see, they're going to,
they renewed his amnesty there.
Yes.
And he was actually happy about it.
But now we're hearing rumors that he might be sent over as a gift.
As the, yeah.
But
an actual gift, mind you.
They put it. They're really going to put a fucking bow on this.
I mean,
guy.
I would love this. If it happened, I mean,
I don't want it.
I know you don't, and truthfully, I don't want to see him get handed over.
But here's the reason why. If he gets handed over, it just solidifies and puts a stamp and a bow on the Trump administration as being one of the most hypocrisy. The hypocrisy is running rampant. You're going to give this man away, who is known as a treason.
But they are praising Julian Assange.
And you have people legitimately breaking your law and committing actual treason.
Yes.
And is being resigned.
Back to Julian Assange, though, the reason I brought up even Julian Assange is he's actually the guy who sent Snowden to Russia.
Yes.
Snowden wanted to go to Latin America.
Yeah.
Assange set him up with people from the Kremlin.
He did.
Mm-hmm.
And now you have Assange giving... And by the way, the whole defense of Julian Assange is this. Julian Assange never directly said anything about not directly getting it from Russia. So those that are saying, no, he didn't get it from Russia, you're wrong. You're wrong. You're just wrong.
Wrong.
Wrong. Wrong. You're just wrong. He said, our source is not backed or held by any state. Something along those lines. But literally, that was what it was. The source that he said he claims to have is not held accountable by anybody. That does not... I don't know how that filters into some people on the left that says, oh, that Russia had nothing to do with it. And I get it. I get what some people are saying about how we don't want to start World War III. We don't want to do this. But guys, we can't let a fucking government, another foreign government, rule our fucking government too, man.
Right.
I mean, come on. What happens when the next guy comes? What if Bernie Sanders runs next time? What's gonna happen? He's gonna get fucked. He's gonna get screwed. But you know, back to our initial story though. But yeah, the intelligence community is just blowing the fuck up right now on the Trump administration because let's just face it, this is what Trump gets for warring with the intelligence community.
It does. I mean, it's crazy.
Steve, let me ask you, at this point in time, with all the, you know, I've always used the argument, you don't need a body to convict someone of murder. Right. I think the same should be said about situations like this. When you have one too many coincidences from... You know, I didn't even mention that his staff is apparently, now that's breaking news too, his staff has apparently been talking to Russian officials too.
Yes.
So you had campaign...
It's coming out now.
You had campaign officials talking to Russia, you had Carter Page, you had Paul Manafort, you had the RNC platform change to favor Russia, you have Donald Trump refusing to go say anything negative about him whatsoever, you have the already apparent embrace of Putin by the alt-right, and by the new public policy polling, they believe Donald Trump should just be able to override judges. Thus, proving my point, ladies and gentlemen, they like to be strong-armed. They like an authoritarian to tell them what to do.
No,
they do. But, Steve, I'm sorry. Let me ask you the question I was getting to. At this point, with everything that you've seen and everything we've covered, do you think that there is something, at least a conspiracy, going on within the White House?
All right, I'm going to give you my very short answer, and then because there's no way to answer this in a sentence, so the short answer is yes, it is a conspiracy, but here's the long-winded answer, and it's going to revolve around, I swear, it's going to be like a boomerang. Let me just fast forward to recent events. A White House advisor, I think you guys seen this, it's been crazy, and I promise you it's going to be relevant. He comes by the name Stephen Miller.
Oh, yes, no,
and,
I did see
and
that.
He
I
comes
was going
to
touch on that a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, and
yes.
He was on
all the news networks.
All the news networks.
Yes,
oh, yeah,
the NBC and CNN.
Did you not see this, Joseph Goebbels?
Yeah.
My God.
I mean, again, I said White House advisor, okay? And he comes out on national media, and he talks about the immigration ban and everything else. But then he talks about something
that's,
like that.
That wasn't the story. You are now sugarcoating, my friend.
Yeah, he
the big story is that the president shall not be
questioned. Not only will he not be questioned, but he is right 100% of the time. Now, what does that sound like? It sounds like every other dictator we've ever heard. It sounds like Kim Jong-un type stuff.
Let me tell you, and you know, I'm sure some of you are going to say, wow, CD Rob, that is harsh and brutal, but...
The guy said it out of his mouth.
Let me just tell you what I... When I first heard this guy talking, I actually caught it on Morning Joe, and I heard Morning Joe's rant on it, and I was like, wow, that would not have been my response. After he said the whole, the president shall not be questioned, my response to him would have been, okay, shall I take you out in the back of the shed and shoot you? Because, no, I'm not joking, because this is exactly the kind of people that Winston Churchill talked about when it came to Nazism.
It was
those people that are so blind to follow are dangerous like that.
It's in the Mason Constitution, guys. It's legitimately in the White House on the wall. It's it's basically there. It's federal. Oh my god! It's so crazy that this man would go out and basically. I don't know if you guys know, but I mean, I'm sure you guys do. It's attacking us.
Yeah.
It's not just saying corporate media, mass media. It's saying everything. The
bow down
will not be questioned.
Bow down.
He is 100% right every single time. And you know what's crazy about this? President Trump went out immediately after he said this.
He praised him.
Thank you going out there, and of course he would say that because you know he's too busy bitching at Nordstrom's Rack about his fucking daughter's clothing line and everything else and golfing to pay attention to people like
his
him.
Third vacation, I might add.
I mean, here's the thing. Him, guy, people like, I'm still answering the question. The guys like him, Stephen Miller, women like Kellyanne Conway, guys like Sean Spicer, they go out, they make just ridiculous. I mean, seriously, we can't say, I've said this to CT Rob off air. And text messages, and I've called him, and I was like, this is basically, it's not, is it or is it not, this is dictatorism at its finest.
It's divide and conquer.
You're pretty much. And this is, I mean, I can't even, like, coherently say it because there's so much shit, but how can you have a president of the United States mentally be capable of not understanding that one of your national security advisor is leaking information to Russia, and you know nothing about it for a month. And if you don't know anything about it, then people surrounding you should know. It's their job.
Yeah.
That's the main thing. You know that thing of, you got one job to do. You had one job. You
Steve,
have
Steve,
one thing.
Steve, this is Donald Trump, president, okay? I got a lot of things to do, okay? Okay, there's plenty to do. I have vacations to take. I have a lot of golf.
Right,
to do,
I know.
Okay?
You need someone to roll up your incredibly long ties. It's the guy is... I was listening to something, and they were saying, is he even mentally capable? Is he mentally there? And I don't think he is, because if you are a president of the United States and you don't know that your national security advisor is leaking information and no one around you is leaking information, you're going to ballroom diners with other world leaders and getting emergency damning information.
Let me stop you right there too. That damning information you're talking about was the North Korea situation. That by the way was publicly. People were taking pictures.
We could have gone there.
We could have
gone there. As the Minutemen and been like, guys, we took a picture.
Yeah, seriously.
It's crazy.
On that whole Korea thing. So that let me just add to that a little bit. So they freaked out about that Korea thing, but when Russia just did a missile test, where's Donald Trump now?
No Twitter, no press conferences, no idiots coming out on the media, nothing. And this is again, this is the boomerang effect. I'm coming around to the conspiracy that it is the Trump administration is a conspiracy.
Yeah.
I don't care what kind of goons that they sent out. I just said it earlier in the show, one of their goons, Kellyanne Conway. They are breaking her, and I don't feel bad for her 1 minute because she's picked and chose her side, and she can quit anytime like and everybody else is. She's going out there. She looks like, I don't want to do this anymore. I know I'm lying to the American people.
Listen to me, Steve. You are not argue against my alternative facts. My alternative facts are super and mighty. Your He-Man strength will not overcome me. I am Kellyanne.
Bye,
Conway.
buy Ivanka? I mean, dude, I mean, she's out there pimping out Ivanka's...
Buy Ivanka Trump.
Oh my God. It's like a bad, like... Dude, I mean, you were so right. It's like... I can't... People can't shit on North Korea without shitting on America first. I mean, in North Korea, again, we're going to get into this too, but, you know... You know, whether or not is there a conspiracy of his half-brother being, killed with poison darts?
It was actually assassination.
Yeah, it was assassination, by poison darts. Now, when's the last time you've seen or even heard of anybody being assassinated by poison darts? Okay. I would have to say probably in an Indiana Jones movie. I mean, but C.T. Wobb said it earlier in the show, not jokingly, because it is. It's like we are living in a bad action movie, and it's just
declining. It's not an action movie. It's a horror movie.
You know what, Squid, you called it right. It's a horror movie. And people thinking it's funny right now, I mean, listen, we're joking about it. You know, it is funny in ways. But
we're serious about
this. Please. This is damaging and horrifying for people to come out on national media basically saying, shut up, you know nothing, the president is all-knowing, all-seeing. Dude, he was talking about, like, planet Earth, about, like, he was, like, the ruler of the planet Earth. One time I was like, is this guy, like, legitimately, like, talking like... like an alien from Mars attacks? I was like, what the hell is going on here?
Yeah.
I was like in like lunacy mode, but I want to flip the script and ask you too, Rob. Do you yourself, and Squid, you could join in as well, do you think that this is a conspiracy? And if so, if it's a conspiracy, has this been the most damaging conspiracy in an administration we've ever had?
Okay, well, that's a two-part one. Yeah, I do. I actually think it is. I'm going to even go a little further on this and tell you that this story is not going to stop. I've made predictions on this show already that have come true. One of them was this Edward Snowden. The other one was this, the whole Russian involvement. No, I am not surprised by any of this stuff coming forward because it was eventually going to spill over anyway. We live in a world of where you can't really have a phone conversation without, you know, someone hearing it, let alone emails. So... yeah, some information was going to get out, and I think this is just the tip of the shipberg, really, if you really want to know. No, I don't think there's been an administration so far with as much conspiracy, which, you know, I hate to say it, I'm not trying to start any fights, but it makes it almost an illegitimate administration when you have this much foreign affairs in it, and I know I've said that before, but I really do believe that. I actually really do. You know, a lot of people on the left, and I hear a lot of this from secular talk, for instance, that, you know, oh, what do you think he is? You think he's Putin's bitch? No, I don't think he's Putin's bitch. I think you're going a little too far on that level. But what he is if you look at this, what the situation of Russia is, where all their income is based off oil, their GDP is very corrupt. I mean, they basically want to make it like America. I mean, it's like the perfect relationship, really. It's a relationship for money. That's what it is. They're going to rob Russia and America. They're going to rob both the countries, and they're going to get away with it, and that's what they want to do. Basically, Donald Trump, I actually kind of say this, he sees the way Putin has made Russia. Basically, everything that is touched in Russia goes into Putin's pockets. Putin has his hands on everything. There's not one thing Putin does not touch in Russia that he has not any control over. I mean, that's just a fact. But... yeah, I do. I think now he's not only is he trying to mimic Putin's authoritarianism, but he's trying to divide and conquer. I mean, we've seen it with the public, we've seen it with the media, we've seen it with the intelligence agency. He's basically trying to divide it to where whatever he says is right and whatever anybody else says is fake.
And it's crazy.
The administration behind him is just going along with it. But what I'm even more scared about is how... where are the Republicans? Will the real Republicans please stand up right now? I mean, whatever happened to embracing Ronald Reagan? Whatever happened to all that we're patriots? Whatever happened to the whole, you know, we don't like foreign governments and everything? I mean, what happened to all that?
What happened to the drained swamps? Where are these people that were just raging against the establishment that voted for Trump because he was anti-establishment?
Yeah.
Now, again, I'm not... Rob is bringing up such a good point. He's not bashing them. He's wondering... where are they? Why aren't they coming out? in the droves they were just months ago. And like it or not, you're going to need those people. You're going to need those people that were voting against, for Trump. Because they're the ones, too, that are saying, like, wait a minute. You know, I voted for this guy because I thought that he was telling the truth. And you can't hate a guy for that. You know, you're thinking he's telling the truth. You're telling him he's not. He's going to vote for the guy anyways. You know, and he made a mistake. Yeah, I mean, if you can't hate this guy, all right? You can disagree with him. And we have.
Yeah.
But you're going to need him. He's not going to go away. You can't just say he voted for Trump. Damn him to hell and back.
I disagree with you, actually. I just believe we have to outvote them. I think it's not about those voters anymore. I think they're too far gone. You know,
not all of them, though.
Not all of them, but the ones in the Rust Belt, I don't think are.
No, I think they're turning.
The ones who voted for Trump for economic reasons.
They're too far gone.
No, not those. Not the ones for economic reasons up there in the Rust Belt, like Pennsylvania, Michigan, with all the states he flipped. Now, legitimately, I think those people will turn. But there are his base, that 32-37% that he has or whatever it is. Those are the people I don't think are ever going to go away. And if they do, and this is one of my predictions here, and the minute that number cracks, they're going to jump all over him for impeachment.
I definitely think they would. I mean,
as soon as his base goes away, I think they will. But go ahead, Squid.
I want you to finish what you were going to say, and then I'm going to jump in with my thoughts.
Well, the thing is, we're just going to need them. Here's my take. We're the people anyways, right? There's one side of the coin that voted for Democrats, one side of the coin that voted for Republicans, and there's a large majority that didn't vote. You're going to need those people. But Rob is completely right, and I do agree with him. Yeah, we need the majority. We need to not stop the fight of trying to not argue our point, but just now it's facts time. It's persuading, and it's not even just persuading. It's just presenting the facts.
No.
Here's what's going on. Here's what people are putting out. There are facts readers by the week in like staggering numbers. Just off the things Trump is doing on his Twitter, and that is coming out of his mouth. People are bringing up facts every single week. So it's those people, just like you said, on an economical reasons, the people in the swing states, they're changing their mind. Definitely right now. I don't know for sure, so I'm not going to speculate.
Well, the reason I say the other his base voters were not going to change is because when you looked at that new poll, Rachel Maddow actually did a report on it, on the public policy polling that came out. Basically, the base that said he should be allowed to overturn judges he doesn't like, that's insane. That's just simple. That means you don't give a shit about checks and balances, about branches of government. You don't care.
You're attacking judges.
He might as well be king. If that's the point, then make him emperor. Make him king.
And that was one thing that Rob has said previous show. I'll get to you, Squid. But he's right. I'm sorry I keep agreeing with, but he, you know what? The guy is going too far he's already gone too far, but he's going too far as attacking federal judges.
Yeah.
Well, from legal documents, it's a federal action to question that state. And he's basically going out and sending people out there to say, tell them physically, do not go against me. Do not oppose me. I am the president. I have the power.
I'm gonna stop right there real quick, and I'm going to say this, but did we at least ever expect this? I mean, Donald Trump is a bully. He really is. And he's taking control of his people and then just bullying them into submission. Do it my way or I'm going to find somebody else and replace you. And this goes into my answer with this conspiracy. And I'm going to say, yes, I do believe in it. And you guys may disagree with me on this, but I believe with Michael Flynn and everything, this could possibly lead into another kind of Watergate situation.
No, I think it is.
I agree.
It is. It's going to blow up more. Like I've been saying, there has been Russian taint on this fucking... Russian taint. There's been taint. There's been a lot of taint on this fucking Russian... on this fucking Trump administration. You guys know what I mean, right?
Yeah.
Anyway. But no, this... There's just too much involvement.
Well, there is.
It's just way, there's too many foreign affairs in it. There's too much putting Russia first. I mean, they already talked about lifting the sanctions. And did you hear, Steve? This morning they announced that Congress is trying to pass a bill that makes it so Congress can choose to lift the sanctions. Why would you do that? Why not just get rid of the... I mean, come on now. You're almost proving his guilt with that. And that's why I say I think they know something in D.C.
I think they do, too.
And they're not saying anything. I think...
which is... it's going to hurt them in the long run.
It's pretty crazy right now.
Yeah,
I mean,
there's just too many. There's just
Don't. I want everyone to stay focused, though. The real story about this, though, and believe me, guys, I want my listeners to focus. I want you guys to focus. The real story and what we're all getting down to, when it comes down to the nitty-gritty, to the top of the icing of this cake, it is, did Trump give Flynn the order to make that phone call? Because when you were talking about impeachment, Squid,
direct 6 months worthy of impeachment talk.
Yes, that will lead to impeachment. However, let's go around the table and ask, I want to ask you guys, do you want him to be impeached, and do you think it would be for the better?
I think...
Let's start with you, Steve. Go ahead.
I'm just going to go ahead and say, of course, that's the answer that we're all going to want to hear is, yeah, he needs to be impeached. But not only the impeachment is more of like, for at this point, is more of just a step one phase. It's more or less now, do you understand why he's being impeached? Because he can be impeached and people don't know. Like, people still are praising Bill Clinton and the man was impeached. You know, people don't care. You know, they're like, oh, you know, I love him. I'll vote for him again.
President. He can have sex with whoever he wants. All right.
I mean, but you get what I'm saying. It's, you know, the guy can get impeached and people won't bat an eye at it. They're like, so what? You know, whatever. He was impeached, but he was still. They're gonna still have that mind frame. But they need to understand why the man is impeached, what he's been doing. And yeah,
but this is a way different. I mean, this is literally putting another government in front of this country that this government may possibly have dirt on you to blackmail you first.
Right.
And you're working in the best interest of another country and not the United States. That's
which is he by his own tweet, mind you, he just said that is the most that's un-American.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to answer now, and do I think he's going to get impeached? Yes, I do. Do I believe it's going to be right away? I don't know. I mean, to me, I think it's going to reach about month six before he gets impeached.
I actually don't think nothing will happen.
Really?
I actually believe nothing will happen.
It'll die. It's going to fizzle out.
Because... unless people stay focused on the substance that I'm presenting to you, which is, did he know, did he give the order? That's the main point I'm trying to get to you guys, is did he know? But I don't think he will be impeached. I don't think anything will come of it. The reason why I say that, and even with Elizabeth Warren and everybody else screaming at their top of their lungs, it's because the Republicans will not stand up. I don't know why I've been sitting here kind of thinking about this for a long time on this thought here about why they won't stand up. And one of the reasons, the only one reason that comes to my mind is death of the party.
Right.
One of them is death of the party. And the fact that they're in a position right now of where they've won. They've got everything they need. They've got the power. You know, they've got the limited power. But they do. They have all the power right now. Yeah. But just for one second, and I wanted to ask you, wrap your guys' head around this wrap your guys' head around this narrative for just seconds. Imagine if it is fully impeached. And I just want to say, too, for the record, I don't want Trump to be impeached. I'd rather have him lose in the next 4 years because I don't want Mike Pence, because I think Mike Pence is even sleazier. However, though, I do believe if an impeachment does come, it will lead to the entire administration being gone, which then I don't know. We would be presented with a really interesting circumstance. This one of which this country has never seen before.
It'd be unprecedented.
I think Let me go back to that. That right there, what you just said, that is, I mean, it's beyond the pick your own poison, because on one hand you have your mega power that is just corrupt and you want him out as quickly as possible, but then you just said you have another mega power ready to stand up and take his place.
Yeah.
And yeah, you get the evil and bad, you know, the administration's out, but you don't know what lies beneath. And you were just talking about...
Let me get back to the party, though, real quick. Like, what I was... Right, I'm sorry. Just let me say this, but just imagine... Let me wrap you guys' head around this, though. This is what I was trying to get to, is imagine if it does lead to impeachment. You're going to have a backlash because the Republicans embraced this guy. They embraced the foreign interference.
Yeah.
I mean, some of the dossier that came out in BuzzFeed said the RNC was fully aware of it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one claim that hasn't been substantiated, but that is one that is in the dossier, is that they were fully aware of them cooperating. Not only that, I should mention that Donald Trump even asked Russia to hack the rest of the... to find the rest of the Hillary Clinton emails during the RNC.
Yes, he did.
But... you know, that's what I'm trying to say. Imagine that. Imagine he gets ripped from power. What are the Republicans going to do? I mean, they're going to be standing there at the end of a gun, in the sense of the people are going to be looking at you and saying, you guys went against everything.
It's
going to
be a firing squad.
It will literally be a firing squad upon the Republican
Party. And I'm going to say this right now. I think if this really does happen, I think it's going to be a good idea, because it's going to show which Republicans kind of stay true and did not go with Trump.
I don't think they're going to stand up.
I don't think
you
they
think
are.
So you think if we're... I mean...
I think he's going to get away with it.
I think, yeah, I got to agree with Rob. I think that it is. They're going to get away with it. It's going to be one of those practices of...
It's
going to
be a forever.
It's hot, and it's going to dim down.
They're
going to
use Flynn as a scapegoat. They're going to say, he's a rogue guy.
That's what pisses me off the most, though, is like, they're just going to pin everything on him, but
you
had full knowledge, and this is why I'm going against you guys. I mean, I would really like to see this happen. You guys know how much I hate Trump, and my family absolutely loves Trump. Doesn't think he's done a goddamn bad thing since then. And I smirk every time I see Donald Trump in trouble on the news when we're eating dinner.
Yeah, but
I laugh.
That's the thing. But when they're presented with those scandals, they have nothing to say.
No, they don't.
Well, they do have things to say. They have lies to say. But
alternative facts.
But that's... But here's the thing. That's the funny thing. But it's really not, because, like I said, going back to people like Stephen Miller and Kelly Conway, they're on national television, like I said, where all the eyes are looking at, and they're basically lying, or they're not telling the truth. They're not answering any questions.
Let's be honest, they're lying.
They're lying.
They're lying.
They're lying, or they're just not saying anything. They're not, they're dancing around the questions, and like I said, Kellyanne Conway looks like she's getting just fed up with it.
I loved it.
Which is why they're bringing in a more insane younger guy. And
she would just pull her whole thing, and I would be like, okay, let me... I'd be like, Kellyanne, first of all, let me ask you this other question to answer that question. Can you not stop fucking eating bullshit and spewing it out of your mouth every second and answer my fucking question? The interview would be over within 10 seconds between me and her, but go ahead, though.
But I want to go into that, too, and I think I brought this up. It's Sean Spicer, our new, or whatever he is.
The White House press secretary.
Yeah, the press secretary. Him and Kellyanne's conversations have been going different ways. And I brought this up to you, Steve, and just... Do you think they should actually work together? But I'm going to tell you this right away. Kellyanne was given the job opportunity first, but she turned it down.
You're referring as to who should be working with who?
Sean Spicer and Kellyanne Conway.
Should they be working together?
Stories are actually together. Do you think they...
He's saying there's... Well, I can answer that question real easy for you, Squid, because they're not communicating. There's no collaboration.
Yeah.
There is literally...
There's nothing.
Secret dealings going on in this White House. I'm just going to come out and just say, all hands off, I full-on believe there is some secret, covert shit going on right now. The GOP knows it. The White House knows it. The Democrats definitely know it. But they are trying, they are either waiting their time or they're not doing anything about it. I believe everyone knows about it, but they're not doing anything about it. I think because where would we be if we rip him out of power? If we have to rip that whole administration out of power, where would we be then?
We would be in See, this is the thing. We can't, I mean, we would be in the unknown.
We need to have Mike Pence or nothing at all.
Yeah, we're going to get Mike Pence. No, it wouldn't be nothing at all. It would be Mike Pence for sure. But I mean, as far as the administration, we'd be in the unknown. Because that right there, let me tell you guys something. People might disagree with me, but this is just how I feel. I think at this point right now, with the administration being compromised as it is, being without this administration into an unknown administration is the most. It's even more dangerous.
I agree.
Than when
I'd rather have the scarecrow right now in power than the wizard.
Because
right
the evil right now has a face, guys, and you don't want a faceless evil ruling. You just don't want that. Because that means all the inner workings and all the deals will be. I'm telling you, Rob is. He's right on this, and I gotta agree with him. They will go away so fast, and that this will be the last. If we see a faceless administration, you will never hear a single peep out of any of those people again. Yeah. You will only see what they want you to see. So yeah, it hurts and it's ridiculous now.
That's actually scary,
but
what
it's
you
true.
Just brought up right there, because I actually think that's going to happen now. I actually think now that they've been caught and they're going to use Flynn as a scapegoat. They're going to completely pull this veil over everybody's eyes. And
all eyes are on him.
Do you think? I mean, right? I mean, they're going to find these leaks. I mean, I just think they're going to purge. They're going to have a purge somehow. You know, whether you want to call it or not, but they're going to have to do a purge to find these leaks. Although that is another mystery in its own: is who's doing the leaks. Some people say it's Kellyanne. Some people say it's Steve Bannon. Some people say it's Trump himself. Because his morale, there's been reports on his morale alone, you know, being very bad, like we've said, but...
Yeah, I mean, but there's been also reports of him just basically saying that he doesn't even want to be the actual president.
No.
Yeah,
he's actually done with it.
And I brought this up to Rob Taylor, and he's probably thinking to himself, this is not the job I thought it was going to be like. I thought it was going to be like smooth sailing, and he's finding out...
He thought he was going to, you know... Put his socks on and start slipping around on the floor like, you know, it's a good old time, but it's not. You know?
But
he's like, aliens, economy, war. Who needs this shit? Believe me.
As you know, he's still actually using his old Android phone in the Oval Office. And a lot of NSA guys are telling him, cannot keep using this phone. It's or going to get hacked.
His fucking phone is the least of my worries. My worries is him throwing out people like I just said, like a Stephen Miller out there trying to scare the shit out of people. But yeah, you know what's funny? I don't know if you guys know this about this guy. I'm gonna just lead
Stephen
in here
Miller?
For a sec. Yeah, did you guys know that he went to Duke University, right?
No way.
Yeah, you know, we had a friend there, right, who went to Duke University. Wasn't it the Spencer, right? The neo-Nazi?
Really?
Richard
I did
Spencer
not
went there.
Know
And not
that.
Only did
Holy
he
shit.
Go to Duke, they actually know each other. Now,
wow.
This is not for me, guys. Richard Spencer
did you know?
Went out and said that he was trying... He's keeping quiet right now to not harm the Trump administration.
Did you know that Stephen Miller also came out of Jeff Sessions' office? Yeah.
Yes, he did. Yep. And it... See, now... That kind of get it just that adds for me the whole conspiracy thing.
That's all subject to the racism that I talk about.
But it's also fueling the conspiracy. It has to.
Yeah.
You bring in a guy that fucking like people because you know what? That's
don't mention
knowledge.
Jews at a fucking at the memorial.
Right.
Bring in Nazis to the administration. You know.
But Rob, let me ask you this. But like you said about this being conspiracy, does that fuel you more that they throw a dope like him out there? This is common knowledge. Now again, you guys could just research it.
I told
Google.
You how I felt about it. I felt very when I heard him say those things. I was like, you know, I don't know whether like my whether
how scared
call,
can you get anymore?
Well,
you know?
Well, I don't know whether it's my patriotic self telling me to just kill you, or you know, in my you know me being a civil person and saying, "Wow, you need to get slapped in the face." Those were the only two options.
I think he's had abuse. He's like that kid, you know, a little kid that got the shit kicked out of him all his life. Now he's like, "Yeah, I'm in the White House now.
Who rules the world now?
Who rules the world?" Dude, he was talking about planet Earth.
Jumpsuit now. now who's on the big? Now who's wearing the big boy pants and on the big boy screen? Stephen Miller, baby. Stephen Miller.
Oh my God.
The president will not be questioned. God damn it.
Dude, I mean, a complete affiliation.
Did you guys see that picture of how they compared him to Joseph Goebbels?
Yes,
let me tell you something. I had a joke, and I'm going to say it right here on air, and I hope you people love it, because I've been trying to fit this in, and now that the comparison between Trump being Hitler, Stephen Miller being Goebbels, does that make Alex Jones his Rudolf Hess?
Oh.
I mean,
you're gonna see
fucking Alex Jones in a plane flying over to Russia, like, like, he said he wanted peace.
Yeah, I know, you're gonna be hearing him just screaming out, "The frogs are gay!
The frogs are gay! Drain the swamp, the frogs are gay!"
Oh my God.
But, you know, real quick, though, I want to jump on one point, though. I do actually have to give Donald a little bit of credit here. He did do something that he did prove me wrong on a point, and like I've always told our listeners, I will tell you when I am wrong, and I will tell you that when something I predicted will not happen. I predicted this, and I'm actually more happy he backed down off of it, and it's not going to happen. So the One China policy, Donald Trump recently spoke to the president of China, and he said that they will stay true to the One China policy,
right,
which to me brought a lot of relief, meaning that Taiwan will not be taken militarily and nothing bad will happen to Taiwan. However, that same day, there was a very close call in the South China Sea between an American plane and a Chinese vessel.
Yes.
So, you know, take the good with bad.
That's what I mean.
Just saying, ladies and gentlemen. That's the only thing I wanted to really add that was maybe the silver lining of today's show.
I mean,
we're not going to war with China.
I know.
But
we're not. What kind of, like,
we still might go to war with China. We might not. You know.
I mean, like, did you guys? I mean, this is like real life, man. Every time I'm like, damn, this is real shit.
It feels like we've been reporting on his administration for a fucking year.
But I mean, you can't. I'm going to, like, quote one of my favorite comedians here, and Lewis Black. He was just like, you can't write this shit.
Yeah.
No,
you just can't write it. It's so fucking hard.
And that's why I believe people don't believe the Russia thing, is because people are like, it's just so crazy. It's like, but isn't that the whole point behind conspiracies and some things sometimes, is you hide it in the open? It's so crazy. It's true. How many times have you seen that it's so crazy it was true, or you can't make this stuff up?
I mean,
and believe me, when we started the show, we told you, and I had CT Ducky on the show, and he said, "That's a little much, Rob," when I said, "I think Trump is a fucking Russian fucking spy. I think he's a fucking puppet." And everyone's like, "Oh, that's a little much." But now look where we're at.
I know, look where we're at.
Look where we're at.
It's crazy. I mean, we've got to call you Nostradamus in a minute, because this is getting, like, way out of hand. I mean, the whole, just like you said, you hide conspiracies in plain sight. I mean, just like I said, guys, I just gave you that information about the Richard Spencer thing. That is common knowledge. A simple Google, you can get it yourself. I mean, but that's what I mean. It scares the shit out of you. Oh, here he is on television,
those
acting like a
ass devil bastards. I can't believe them. Can you believe that? I did not know they even wanted to do.
No, I mean, it's not surprising though. I mean, some kind of connection.
I would like to see someone punch Richard Spencer dressed up as the Blue Devil.
Oh my God! Yes.
No, I go one above that. I think someone should throw an actual dildo at him. There you go.
Like the one guy in fucking New Zealand?
New Zealand.
Yeah.
One of the top five most funniest political things I've ever seen. If no one knows what we're talking about, there was a situation where a protester threw a dildo at one of the public officials in New Zealand. I mean, it hit him square in the
face. Not only did it hit him square in the face, it made such a good slapping sound.
Yeah, it was perfect rubber on face ratio.
And then he smiled. He gave a smirk.
And he went, oh!
Like, oh, there it is.
Like, he was not expecting it. Or he was expecting
it. No, like, he was expecting it. Like, hey, thanks.
Well, like, this has happened to him, like, once or twice. Like, oh, there's just a dick that hit my face.
Dude, I'm not kidding, though. At this point, I think you gotta battle crazy with crazy, you know, in a dumb way. I'm gonna just buy a bunch of them and start throwing at them.
But,
and,
you know, I wanted to touch on something you've been saying a lot, Steven. I've been hearing this a lot from the left, and we're going to end the show with this, too. And I just want to give this one final thought to our listeners here. This idea that all conspiracy theorists are crazy, all conspiracy theorists are evil, all conspiracy theorists are crazy. Well, you know what? We've moved a lot from the conspiracy theory aspect to bring you guys more of what we view as news, you know, more than the far right-wing fucking crap we have out here in AZ. But the point I'm trying to make is that the things we're talking about, some people may say they're conspiracies, but they're quickly becoming news. Politics has almost become a conspiracy now. There's so much out there, that sometimes you need people to help you filter through all this bullshit, and that's what we're here to do for you on the Minutemen. That's going to be our show today. We want to thank all our true listeners that have stuck with us since we started the show and that know that we were the ones to first bring up this Russian involvement. I thank you guys for that. I thank you guys for the support. This show's going to be growing more and more. Our credibility, as everyone knows, is getting better.
It's growing by the day, guys.
I mean, we've been proven right so many times now on this show that people who aren't paying attention need to start paying attention. So I appreciate those who spread the word about us, who listen to us, who give us retweets, and we give our thanks. Yeah, and we're honored for your follows, and we're honored for your guys' listens. But, hey, listen, like, subscribe, guys. This is CT Rob with the Minutemen saying out.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in you.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to start a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire, and that one desire is you, and I know nobody else ain't gonna do.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same,
I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire.
just want to start a flame in your heart.